guys, welcome to this video on finding the slope. So I'm assuming that you already know how to find the slope of a line when given the equation of a line. We know that the standard form for the equation of a line is y equals mx plus b, where m is our slope and b is our y-intercept. We also know that slope is rise over run, or y over x. But now, how do we find the slope of a line when only given 2 points on a graph? Let's take a look. So we have our graph. So we have 2 points on our line, 1, 3, and 3, 7. But how do we find the slope of the line? Well, we can do this by dividing the difference of the y-coordinates of the 2 points you've been given by the difference of the x-coordinates from the same set of points. Let me just write out mathematically everything that I just said. So, we find the slope by dividing by the difference between our y-coordinates. This can be written like this. Y sub 2 minus y sub 1. All over, because we're dividing. So that is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And this will be equal to our slope. Now, you just need to plug in your y values and your x values. But here's another very important thing that many students get confused about, and it's a great question. Which set of coordinates are my x1 and y1, and which set of coordinates are my x2 and y2? The answer is, it doesn't matter. However, what you can't do is assign x1 to the x value in a set of coordinates and y2 to the corresponding y value. For example, in our points here on the graph, I couldn't say that my 1 here is my x1 and that my 3 here is my y2. If I make 1 here x1, then my corresponding y value here has to be y1. What doesn't matter is whether or not I make this set of points my x1, y1, or this set of points my x1, y1. So, now let's pick whichever point we want to be our x1, y1, and for this video, I'll just say that 1, 3 will be our x1, y1, which makes 3, 7 our x2, y2. Now, let's plug in our values. Since 7 is our y2, we have 7 minus our y1. And our y1 is equal to 3. Over the difference between our x values. x2, which is 3, minus x1, which is 1. So we have 7 minus 3 over 3 minus 1. So this is going to give us 4 over 2, which reduces simply to 2 over 1, which is the same thing as 2. Just to show you guys that it doesn't matter which set of points you make your x1, y1, and x2, y2, I'll switch them around. So let's make 1, 3, x2, y2, and 3, 7, x1, y1. When we plug them in, we get 3 minus 7 over 1 minus 3 is equal to negative 4 over negative 2. And we have a negative divided by a negative, we get a positive. So this simply reduces to 2 over 1, or 2. So we see that our two answers are the same, and that it does not matter which set of coordinates we assign to be our x1, y1, and x2, y2. I hope this video has been helpful to you. For further help, be sure to subscribe to our channel below. See you next time.